Will Thelander and his family have been farming in Pinal County for several decades, beginning with his grandfather in the 1940s. The Tempe Farming Company grows crops such as cotton, alfalfa, and corn.
Been great. Started off just helping out, then got more and more duties around the farm. Eventually became a partner a few years back. And yeah, it's been going great. With all these water cuts that we've been facing, and so it's going to be a lot more difficult moving forward.
Thelander is referring to the Tier 1 cuts along the Colorado River approved by the U.S. Bureau of Reclamation. The Central Arizona Project, or CAP, is an expansive and expensive system that won't be able to deliver as much water as usual to the middle of the state.
The Tier 1 cuts, specifically our irrigations district, their contract with the CAP, and we're getting cut back by a ton of it. So now instead of getting surface water from the Colorado, we're going to have to do a lot more ground water pumping. So that's what it means. We're going to have a lot less water.
Any idea on the number of farmers in this area that are going to be impacted by this Tier 1?
Farms our size, there's about, I want to say like 8 really big farms that are going to be making massive decisions this year on how much to plant and equipment and all that stuff.
During this monsoon, which has dropped record rainfall in cities like Tucson, Thelander's situation seems surreal. On our way to his farm west of Casa Grande, the raging green wash adjacent to I-8 kept us from reaching his property. We detoured to his cousin's farm instead.
Does it seem ironic that we couldn't get to your farm because of this wash running so heavily right now?
Yeah, I know. Very ironic because wish I could just build a giant reservoir and catch it all so I'd have water for next year, but life doesn't work that way. I wish those monsoons would just wait until the winter and go snow up in the Rockies.
The Colorado is fed by that snow melt, but this monsoon rain is a different story. It is very much appreciated, but unpredictable as a long-term solution.
Well, yeah, everyone's just like, oh, it rains, so now we have water. It's like, nope, there's reservoirs have to be above the city. So Phoenix, Tucson, reservoirs, water can flow down. It doesn't. We got a bunch of water raining right here. We can pump it once it sinks in, but not a lot sinking in when you got a river flowing. So yep, unfortunately, this doesn't help with the Colorado. The district's doing everything it can to drill wells throughout the district to try to move as much water as we can to keep as much in production as we can.
Thelander has already stopped using hundreds of acres on his farm in order to save water, and he's also experimenting with plants that require less irrigation. Farmers, he says, are trying their best as the competition for this precious resource heats up.
So every single thing we can do, we're trying. There's only so much you can do. People are always going to come first. And when there's only so much water, development for people makes a lot more money than agriculture on a per acre or a land basis. So you're not going to win money-wise, and you're not going to win, hey, tell people they can't have water. And the amount of water agriculture uses compared to the, you know, civilian population, it's like, I think it's 80% of all water goes to agriculture. So we're going to be the first cut. One thing I hear from a lot of people online, because some of the other interviews, is the fact that we shouldn't be farming in the desert anyway. And then my retort to that is, all the farmers and everyone built all the infrastructure for all these people to move out here. Without us, none of these people would be here. And to that point, should we have people living in a desert? Should we build a city in the middle of a desert? I don't know. These are all questions that everyone could be asking themselves. It is what it is. And who am I going to yell at? The clouds for not dumping enough snow in the Colorado, for them over allocating the Colorado River a while ago when we were in a wet period, when the scientists even know we were in a wet period. So, I mean, there's no one to be mad at. It's just do everything you can and keep moving forward.